Hello and welcome to another demonstration of the iFIX OPC UA server. In this demonstration, we will introduce you to the Global Discovery server and show you how to use it to configure both a client and the OPC UA server for iFIX to talk to each other securely using this central but Global Discovery server, sometimes abbreviated to GDS. To begin with, I'll give you a quick introduction to the Global Discovery Server. This is part of the OPC UA specification, section 13. The GDS provides a central repository where OPC UA clients and servers can register for two main reasons. One is so that clients can easily find registered servers as a way to browse what's available, and two, it is an important factor in providing a central certificate repository for trust between clients and servers, allowing clients and servers to register with one central server and update trust lists so that they can then trust each other without having to manually copy and use certificates back and forth for each and every connection. So I won't go too much deeper than that. I'll open up the Global Discovery Server, start it up. And so, just a quick note, this Applications tab shows all of the applications that are registered with this Global Discovery Server. Currently, there are none, but we'll see those show up as we register our iFIX OPC UA server and an OPC UA client, in this case, a Simplicity OPC UA client. To start, you'll notice in the iFIX OPC UA server configuration utility that we've provided a certificate tab to help you with this process. Currently, our iFIX certificate is self-signed. It hasn't been signed by a certificate authority like the GDS, and we've provided you very straightforward buttons below to do this registration process for you, or make it easier for you. To start with, when we hit the Configure GDS button, you can see that through Local Discovery Servers, this configuration tool has located the GDS running on the different machine that I just showed you. So you can see we have a list of Global Discovery Servers we could pick from if there are more than one on the network. Most likely you just have one. But here we're going to try to connect to that Global Discovery server for registration. So you can see we can test that out, and we can see that we are able to successfully connect to it. Now that we have a successful connection to that Global Discovery server, we can just go ahead and request that the GDS sign I certificate. So we'll do that. You can see it goes through and is successful in doing that. Now, you'll notice the difference in our certificate is now, instead of self-signed, it is certificate authority issued from that Global Discovery server on that other machine that is running the GDS. So we'll save that. And if you look at back at the Global Discovery server, you can see that we are now registered with the GDS. And what we can do now is, if we start up the Simplicity OPC UA, and if we wanted to find our OPC UA server through the global directory or Global Discovery server, you can see we can see that server available and can select our security endpoint and test that connection. You can see that the client wasn't able to trust that server because currently this client doesn't know has not registered with the Global Discovery server and has not had its certificate signed by the GDS. So now we have a mismatch. So what needs to happen is both client and server need to register with that central GDS in order for that trust to happen. So if we go into the client's security configuration, Now, this is Simplicity's security configuration, and it is also GDS aware. In a different set of videos, you can see how to register any OPC UA client with a GDS through an agent tool. But in this case, it's built right in. So we're going to go ahead and register this Simplicity server or client with that same GDS. So we'll just hit our enable security button. You can see it's finding the GDS, registering with it, and we'll go ahead and resign that certificate. Now that we've successfully registered with the GDS on the client side, if we go back to our client and try to connect again, that trust should be established between the two, client and server. Oh, you can see that didn't quite work. So what did we do wrong? So what actually is another step that's required on the iFIX side is once you've signed your certificate with the Global Discovery server, in iFIX, we need to restart the workspace or restart iFIX in order for that newly signed certificate to be picked up. So we'll go ahead and do that. We'll shut down iFIX and restart. So iFIX has been restarted and is now running. So now if we go back to our client and test that connection again, you can see that we're successful, because now the two certificates, both on the client and the server side, are both signed by the same Global Discovery server. And if we go look at our Global Discovery server, you can see if we refresh that now the client and the server have both been registered with, you can see this is client and server, and this is just a server.